Vietnamese team has changed a lot over the last 3 or 4 years. The way they played in 2010, a little bit predictable. We knew how Vietnam would play back then. They played the same way for a long time, so working against it was about hard work. It was about trying to stop them. Now, new ideas from the federation, new tactics on how to promote the importance of the national team and putting structure in place to give the national team the best possible opportunity when it comes to international games is proving to be the right way forward. The coach has his own way of playing, which is something we must work against. But what's impressive with Vietnam is the fact that they're, with the greatest respect to Vietnam, their domestic league is not so high, but their national team is exceptional. So the fact that they're able to do this shows good understanding and good foresight from the federation to make the national team a priority and to give them the best opportunity they can. So it's a very different challenge, as I said earlier, it's a very different challenge this Vietnam team coming to face us this time.
Ya, tim Vietnam tentu banyak berubah 3-4 tahun terakhir. 3-4 tahun 2010, cara mainnya 2010 yang mulai ditebak, cara menghentikannya waktu dulu, ya kita harus banyak bekerja keras bagaimana kita bisa tahan permainan Vietnam. Tapi federasi Vietnam datang, dia memberikan ide baru, mereka memberikan prioritas kepada tim nasional, terus taktik juga baru. Ya, pelatih baru akhirnya mereka memberikan kesempatan untuk Federasi Sepak Bola Vietnam memberikan tim nasional untuk jadi lebih baik ke depannya. Mungkin pelatihnya ada gaya sendiri dan luar biasa. Tanpa mengurangi rasa respect kepada Vietnam ya, liga domestiknya tidak terlalu bagus. Tetapi tim nasionalnya sangat bagus. Dari sini kita bisa tahu bahwa federasinya memberikan prioritas agar tim nasionalnya bisa berprestasi. Supaya mereka ada cara supaya mereka bisa ke depannya lebih baik kepada tim nasional ini.